Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Today we are just going to start the by part of the chapter number 2, measurement. And today topic is standard of length, mass and time. Now first of all, before going to start the standard of length, then what does SI unit mean? Now here, if we talk about the SI unit, so much more thing will come in our mind. First of all, what is the abbreviation of SI means? Now here, SI means stand for System International. SI stand for System International. Second way, this is the convenient for scientific world. SI means stand for System International. It is the convenient for scientific world. Next one is, it provides simple method of calculation. SI provides simple method of calculation. SI provides simple method of calculation. It is a standard under certain physical condition. It is a standard under certain physical condition, and it is used all over the world. It is used all over the world. 7 quantities as fundamental quantities: length, mass, time, temperature, etc. You have learned in the previous class. Now, so we think about that System International SI unit means in 1960 an international conference was held near Paris. It was recommended that a system known as System International be introduced and used all over the world. Units for length, mass and time in this system are meter, kilogram and second. Being the basic units, these are also fundamental units. Means in the previous, most of the scientists performed the experiment in the different ways or in the different units. So what will be happen when it give to the forum of the scientists? So they are just going to perform that experiment much more time, but that results are not going to be related with the actual result. So that is said to be the variation of the results. That's why in 1960, all of the scientists make a conference by which they are confident to take a system by which all of the scientists will work on that system. And if any sort of the scientists not taking the SI system and they are performing in the other unit, so that will not be applicable in the forum of the scientists or in the system, in the scientific theory or in the scientific law. So again, I'm just going to start. In 1960, an international conference was held near Paris. It was recommended that a system known as System International be introduced and used all over the world. Unit for length, mass and time in this system are meter, kilogram and second. Being the basic unit, these are also fundamental units. And in the previously, we have discussed about meter, length, mass, time, temperature, intensity of light, current, and so on. We just have to discuss in the previous class. So that are said to be the fundamental, and in the fundamental, we just have to discuss about that. Now, first of all, at this moment, we are going to discuss or define the 1 meter. Meter is a unit of length. Meter is a unit of length in SI system, or also we can say that is in MKS system. 1 meter, or meter is a unit of length in MKS system, or fundamental units. Now, 1 meter can be defined as, a meter is defined as the distance between two marks, distance between two marks on a platinum iridium. Platinum and iridium are the radioactive elements. Platinum, iridium are radioactive elements. Now, marks on platinum iridium alloy. Alloy, you can say that is a mixture of metals. Alloy bar kept at 0 degrees centigrade in the International Bureau of Weights and Measure near Paris. You can say that 1 meter means that is the length between the two points of a bar which is made by the platinum iridium or radioactive element. It has to be kept at 0 degrees centigrade. So, under the supervision of the International Bureau of Weights and Measure. Now, these persons are very consciously think about that, where they are just going to be kept 1 meter distance or not, or there will be a variation in the 1 meter. So, or in other words, or in the latest system, 1 meter is the length of the path traveled. 1 meter is the length of the path traveled by light in vacuum. 1 meter is the length of the path traveled by light in vacuum during a time interval of 1/299792458 of a second. I mean, you know very well, light can be traveled in a space, or no medium is required to travel a light. So here we are talking about that 1 meter means that is the path traveled by light in vacuum during a time interval of this, okay, of a second. I mean that is the 299792458 part of a part of 1 second. Or in other words, we can say, okay, 1 meter is equal to 16563 wavelength of krypton. Or in other words, we can say, okay, in other words, we can say that, okay, 1 meter means 16507673 wavelength of krypton. And krypton, we can say that is also said to be the radioactive element. Krypton is also said to be the radioactive element. And 1 meter means when it is just going through the move, or when it is, krypton is emitting their radioactive rays, so that wavelength will be equal to like this value. Means wavelength means the distance between the two trees and truck, then it is said to be the 1 meter. Wavelength means the distance between the two consecutive trees or truck, then it is said to be the wavelength. So krypton is also said to be the radioactive element, and this is also emitting the radioactive ray. And which ray it is just going to be going on or emitted, so that wavelength will be equal to like that. Now here, this is the value 3.33 multiplied by 10 raised to the power minus 9 second. That is the value of this. Now, when we are just going to divide 1 divided by this, then it will be equal to like that. Now, if we are talking about the meter, so it having the multiple and sub multiple units. Meter also having the multiple or sub multiple units. Meter, we can say that when we are just going to convert into a smaller to the greater, or is greater into the smaller. So here, first of all, we are just going to transfer greater to the smaller. So 1 kilometer is equal to 1000 meter. 1 kilometer is equal to 1000 meter, and it can be written as the form of scientific notation 10^3 in 10^3 meter. In 1 kilometer is equal to 10^3 meter. In other, 1 kilometer, when we are going to convert in the another submetrical, that is a millimeter. Meter, after that, the next one is a millimeter. And we can say 1 kilometer is equal to 10 lakh millimeter. Or in the scientific notation, we can write 10 raised to the power 6. 1 kilometer is equal to 10 raised to the power 6 millimeter. 1 kilometer is equal to 10 raised to the power 6 millimeter. Now, another way. 1 meter is also said to be the 100 meter, 100 centimeter. 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeter. And 100 centimeter can be written as 10 raised to the power 2 centimeter. Also, I'm just going to be repeated. 1 kilometer is equal to 1000 meter. And 1000 meter we can written as 10 raised to the power 3 meter. Also, we can say 1 kilometer is equal to 10 to the power 3 meter. 1 kilometer means that is the 10 lakh millimeter. 1 kilometer is equal to 10 lakh millimeter. And it can be written as 10 raised to the power 6 millimeter. Now, also we can say 1 kilometer is equal to 10 raised to the power 6 millimeter. Now the next one. 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeter. And 100 centimeter can be written as 10 raised to the power 2 centimeter. Now, when we are going to convert from smaller to the greater, we just have to be divided. Now, look here. Here, from greater to smaller, we are multiplying. Here, from greater to smaller, we are multiplying. But when we are going to smaller to the greater, when we are going to smaller to the greater, then we have to divide it. Now, from this side, we had said that 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeter. So, 1 centimeter will be equal to 1 upon 100. Now, here 100 is multiplied with 1. So, when we are shifting 100 from right to left, so it will come into the division. So, that's why here 1 centimeter is equal to 1 upon 100. And 1 upon 100, 100 means that is the power of the 100 is the 10 raised to the power 2. 100 means 10 raised to the power 2. And when we are shifting 10 raised to the power 2 from denominator to the numerator, so its sign will be converted into the negative. When we will shift denominator into the numerator, so their power will come into the negative. Its power will change into the negative. So we can say okay, 1 centimeter is also said to be the 10 raised to the power minus 2 meter. Now we are going to convert millimeter into the meter. Millimeter into the meter. So we know that 1 meter is equal to 1000 millimeters. 1 meter is equal to 1000 millimeter. So 1 millimeter will be equal to 1 upon 1000. 1 millimeter will be equal to 1 upon 1000. 1 millimeter will be equal to 1 upon 1000. And 1000 can be written as 10 raised to the power 3. When we will shift 10 raised to the power 3 from denominator to the numerator, then its power will come into the negative. And that's why we can say that 1 millimeter is equal to 10 raised to the power minus 3 meter. In other, 1 micrometer is equal to 10 raised to the power minus 6 meter. 1 micrometer is equal to 10 raised to the power minus 6 meter. As well as 1 nanometer is equal to 10 raised to the power minus 9 meter. 1 nanometer is equal to 10 raised to the power minus 9 meter. Again, I'm just going to repeat. 1 centimeter is equal to 10 raised to the power minus 2 meter. All of the students kindly take the screenshot so that you know very well. 1 centimeter is equal to 10 raised to the power minus 2 meter. 1 millimeter is equal to 10 raised to the power minus 3 meter. 1 micrometer is equal to 10 raised to the power minus 6 meter. 1 nanometer is equal to 10 raised to the power minus 9. Now here, for the micro, we are using this mu sign. This mu sign means that is a micro. This N sign or N symbol showing the term nanometer. Now, after that, 1 meter, we get the 1 kilometer. 1 kilogram is the unit of the mass. 1 kilogram is the unit of mass we have learned in the MKS system. And it is also said to be the SI system. 1 kilogram is also said to be the SI system of the mass. 1 kilogram is the SI system of the mass. Now, 1 kilogram can be defined as, now previously we have discussed about the bar, but here we will discuss about the cylinder. We will discuss cylinder. So the mass of a cylinder of a specific dimension, the mass of a cylinder of a specific dimension. Here dimension we can say that is the length multiplied by breadth multiplied by height. Dimension we can say that is the length multiplied by breadth multiplied by height of platinum iridium. You know very well platinum iridium are the radioactive element, and alloy you know very well mixture of element. So kept in the International Bureau of Weight and Measures near Paris is taken to be a standard 1 kilogram. So on previously we discussed about the bar, and here we discuss about the cylinder. But in the both of the country, both of the thing are just going to manufacture the same way like platinum iridium. So also it have been kept at the 0 degree centigrade, so that all of the things should be very, very, very much quite well. Now, we are just going to convert kilogram into the multiple and submultiple, as well as first of all, we have written from greater to the smaller. So 1 kilogram is equal to 1,000 gram, and 1,000 gram can be represented at 10^3 gram. So 1 kilogram is equal to 10^3 gram. 1 kilogram is equal to 10^3 gram. Also, here we are going to convert gram into the milligram. So gram is greater and milligram is the smaller. Gram is greater and milligram is smaller. So here we can also say that 1 gram is equal to 1,000 milligram. 1 gram is equal to 1,000 milligram, and also written as 10^3 milligram. Milligram is represented by the mg, and gram is represented by the gm. Gram is represented by the gm, and milligram is represented by the mg. Also, you can say 1 kg is equal to 10^3 gram. Also, you can say 1 gram is equal to 10^3 milligram. In the calculation, mostly we take these values. When we are going to solve the numerical, we will take this value. When we are going to solve the numerical, then we will take this value. Also, here 1 microgram is equal to 10^-6 gram. Because here we convert a smaller value into the greater value. Here we are converting a smaller value into the greater value. That's why we are writing the power in negative. We are writing the power in negative. So we can say 1 microgram is equal to 10^-6 gram. As well as if we are going to convert nanogram into the gram, so we have to write 1 nanogram is equal to 10^-9 gram. 1 nanogram is equal to 10^-9 gram. Now, after that, in the MKS system, the last one is the S, and S we can say means second, and second is the unit of the time. Now, 1 second can be defined as 1 second is 9192631770 period of vibration of cesium. Cesium is also said to be the radioactive element. Cesium is also said to be the radioactive element, and its atomic number is 133. So that's why we are writing CS. CS is the symbol of the cesium. The CS-133 atom. It means that 1 second means cesium atom vibrate. Cesium atom vibrate like that value. Mean at that value, cesium atom vibrate and it takes just 1 second. So 1 second can be, so 1 second can be defined as 9192631770 period of vibration of cesium CS133 atom. I mean that is the number of vibration. This value showing the number of vibration in 1 second. Okay, when we talk about the time, so we have a different unit of the time. Like we discuss about the year. Sometime we discuss about the century. Somehow we discuss about the month. Sometime we discuss about the week. Sometime we discuss about the day. Sometime we discuss about the hour. Sometime we discuss about the minute. Sometime we discuss about the second. Sometime we discuss about the microsecond. So all of these are said to be the unit of the time. All of these are said to be the unit of time. Now here we are just going to convert their unit from smaller to bigger, and sometime bigger to smaller. Now first of all, if you think about the R, then we can say that 1 hour is equal to 60 minutes. 1 hour is equal to 60 minutes. 1 hour is equal to 60 minutes. As well as after hour, we discuss about the minute. So we can say in 1 second, in 1 minute, there are 60 seconds. In 1 minute, there are 60 seconds. Now we are just going to convert R into the second. So 1 hour will be equal to 60 minutes and 60 seconds. Then we got the product, that is the 3600 seconds. Or in other words, we can say 1 hour is equal to 3600 seconds. We can say that 1 hour is equal to 3600 seconds. After that, we are going to convert microsecond into the second. So 1 microsecond is equal to 10 raised to the power minus 6 seconds. 1 microsecond is equal to 10 raised to the power minus 6 seconds. Now, after that, 1 nanometer is equal to 10 raised to the power minus 9 seconds. 1 nanometer is equal to 10 raised to the power minus 9 seconds. Again, I'm just going to repeat it. 1 hour is equal to 60 minutes. 1 minute is equal to 60 seconds. 1 hour is equal to 3600 seconds. 1 microsecond is equal to 10 raised to the power minus 6 seconds. 1 nanometer is equal to 10 raised to the power minus 9 seconds. Again, I'm going to repeat. 1 hour is equal to 60 minutes. 1 minute is equal to 60 seconds. 1 hour is equal to 3600 seconds. 1 microsecond is equal to 10 raised to the power minus 6 seconds. 1 nanosecond is equal to 10 raised to the power minus 9 seconds. Why we discuss, or why we are going to learn multiple and submultiple of second, of kilogram, of meter? The main thing is that if we are going to solve a numerical, first we think about their units. If the units are not related with the SI system, so first we have to be convert it into the SI system. Either that units are greater or either that units are smaller. So that's why we just have to be discussed or learned about the multiple and submultiple of the units. Now we have the SI prefixes. SI prefixes, we can say that if we are adding some value before the number or after the number, then their value will be changed. ठीक है ना, दीज आर द फैक्टर, दीज आर सेड टू बी द फैक्टर एंड दीज आर सेड टू बी द प्रीफिक्स एंड दीज आर सेड टू बी द सिंबल, दीज आर सेड टू बी द फैक्टर, दीज आर सेड टू बी द प्रीफिक्स एंड दीज आर सेड टू बी द सिंबल. And now here I'm just going to compare greater and smaller value. I mean, in other words, we can say comparison with the greater and its opposite value. Now, first of all, if we say that 10 raised to the power 18, 10 raised to the power 18 means that is the exa. 10 raised to the power 18 means that is the exa, and exa is represented by capital E. Exa is represented by the capital T. Now here, the opposite of the exa is said to be the atto. The opposite of exa is said to be the atto. Atto is represented by the small a. Atto is represented by the small a. Now here, look here. For the exa, the power is, or the value is 10 raised to the power 18. For exa, the factor is 10 raised to the power 18. But their opposite will be atto, and atto value will be, or atto factor will be 10 raised to the power minus 18. Now, the next one is the peta. Peta is represented by the capital P. Peta is represented by the capital P. And its factor is 10 raised to the power 15. The factor of the peta is 10 raised to the power 15. And its opposite is said to be the femto. And femto is represented by the small f. Femto is represented by the small f. And its value is 10 raised to the power minus 15. So we can say the reciprocal of the 10 raised to the power 15 is 10 raised to the power minus 15. Or in other words, we can say okay, the reciprocal of the peta is a femto. The reciprocal of the peta is femto. The reciprocal of the peta is femto. Now, also terra. Terra is represented by the capital T. Terra is represented by the capital T. Terra is represented by the capital T, and its factor is 10 raised to the power 12. Its factor is 10 raised to the power 12. Now, and the opposite of the terra will be the pico. And pico is represented by the small p, and this value is 10 raised to the power minus 12. Now the next one is giga, and giga is represented by the capital G, and their value will be 10 raised to the power 9. And the opposite of the giga, and the opposite of the giga will be the nano. Nano is the opposite of the giga. Now here, nano we can represent it by the small n, while that value will be equal to 10 raised to the power minus 9. After that, mega. Mega is represented by the capital M, and its value will be the 10 raised to the power 6, and its opposite will be the micro. The opposite of the mega is micro. Micro is represented by the small u, and its value equal to 10 raised to the power minus 6. After that, kilo. Kilo, you know very well, represented by the K, and their value is 10 raised to the power 3, and the opposite of the kilo is milli, and it is represented by a small m, their value is 10 raised to the power minus 3. After that, hecto. Hecto is represented by the H, and its value is 10 raised to the power 2, while the opposite of the hecto will become the centi, and centi is represented by the small c, and their value is 10 raised to the power minus 2. And the last one is the deca, and the opposite of the deca is deci. So deca is represented by the da, and the value is 10 to the power 1, while deci is represented by the small d, and its value is equal to 10 raised to the power minus 1. Now you just have to be note down or take the screenshot of the home task. Differentiate between the fundamental and drive units previously, which I have give you. No need to repeat it. The next one is write down the SI unit of the following physical quantity. You also have done previously. The today's work is that define the following term: 1 kilogram, 1 meter, 1 second. Also, you just have to be complete your whole exercise from book page number 29 to 30.